have given you to give to his people. Congregation, Pastor Williams congregation, let God use you for mighty.
Jesus.
Mighty.
Jesus.
In the word.
Praise the Lord. Thank you.
First, I want to give my honor to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is first in my life. I thank God for the water baptism in Jesus' name, according to Acts 2 and 38. I just thank God for the absent apostle, Hasby Jones. I thank God for Pastor Song, Pastor Chief, Deacon Chief, and Pastor Tony Wynn. Thank God for you. Thank God for my grandson. Thank God for the Lord. Even the ones not here, I thank God for you.
Right.
I thank him. I just thank God for waking me up this morning in my right mind. I thank God for a sound mind.
Yes.
I thank him. Thank him for this using this vessel. I just give him the glory because all the glory and praise belong to him.
Yes.
I just thank him. And y'all just keep praying for me. Will God have me to be in his kingdom? And at this time, we'll get down to the word.
Right now.
That's the word of God.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. We're just going to, I'm going to work.
Come on in.
But I'm just kind of hit on something a little bit here.
God use you.
Sometimes God gives you dreams. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you got to understand the devil can play with you in your dreams too.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
He can show you things that is so terrible. And you will say, well, Lord, is this you? This what? But when the devil show you something, you think you're doing it, you'll wake up like, did I do it?
Mm-hmm. Come on.
He's trying to get you back out there. That's how the devil try you. If he can't get you up walking, he can get you in your sleep.
He sure can.
But when God showed you running, I mean, you are running for the Lord. You ain't standing around that ungodly stuff. That means you getting away from it. But when the devil bring you something that it, what you used to do, all thing he's trying to do is shaking you up. He's trying to shake you up, make you scared. And he act like, oh, did I do this? No, you didn't do this. You didn't do it. He just tried. But now if you go out there and do it, then he got you. That means you're going back. So don't let the devil shake you. Don't let him shake you. Jesus. Don't let him come to your mind. Don't let him shake you, because I'm telling you, we got to stay on his word still. So, God gave you this. And I thank God. We coming from Matthew chapter 4. Everybody know that familiar scripture. But God gave me something there.
Come on,
because he gave me a revelation. And I thank God for that. We're going to Matthew 4. And we knew that Jesus was led up. He was hungry, and you know, the tempter tried to come. But we're going to go to verse 4. That's where I'm starting from, verse 4. We'll start at verse 4. Verse 4 says, but he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone,
that's right,
but by every word that proceeds out the mouth of God. Verse 5. Then the devil taken him up into the holy city and setting him on the pinnacle of the temple. Verse 6, and said, and he said unto him, if thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down. For it is written, he shall give his angels charge concerning thee. And in their hand they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. Verse 7 says, Jesus said unto him,
come on,
it is written again, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And verse 8 said again, the devil taking him up into a exceeding high mountain and show him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory of them. Verse 9, and said unto him, all these things will I give thee if thou fall down and worship me. Verse 10 said, then said Jesus unto him, get thee hence, Satan, for it is written,
Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Verse 11 and 11. Then the devil leave him, and behold, the angel came and ministered unto him. If I go give you the topic, it is written.
It is written.
It is written. People don't understand it is written. Because God spoke his word. It's written. Whatever God written, he wants you to do it. Be a doer. A lot of people want to be a doer, but guess what? You ain't got no action behind it. Because God written the word. Whatever God is speaking, it's coming from God. Don't go against God what God tell you what to do. Because God said it's written. See, the devil thought he had a plan with Jesus. He thought now he had a plan with Jesus. But Jesus said, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And that's what God wants his people to do. When that thing comes to you, you tell the devil, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. That's what you got to tell the devil. When you tell him that, he's going to get back and he's going to tuck in and he's going to run. Because he tried Jesus. He wanted Jesus to come up to the mountain. Hey, Jesus, this is the kingdom. Jesus didn't want that. He showed Jesus all this stuff in the world. That's when God said you got to come up among them, be separated. You cannot be of the world. You can't do the things of the world. Amen. But Satan tried Jesus. But Jesus still had a word on because he said it is written. He said that in verse 10. Keep thee, Satan. For it is written, thou shalt worship thy Lord thy God. That means Jesus telling him, you bow down to me.
Yes.
I don't bow down to you.
Jesus.
And a lot of people are bowing down to the devil. They are bowed down to these idolaters, these unclean things. And that's why the Satan want to take you up to the mountaintop. He wants to give you the unclean thing. But Jesus told me to tell you, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God.
Yes.
We got God in us.
Yes, we do.
We are the Son of God. Yes. Why can't you do what God written right here? He said it is written. So use my word for my glory.
Yes.
So when the devil come up to you on your job, you say, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God.
Yes.
You think he won't move? He's going to run.
Yes.
Because he trembled at the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
He can't do nothing with Jesus.
That's right.
Jesus knew him from the beginning.
Yes.
He tried to set God people up.
Yes, he is.
He tried to put them on a pedestal. He tried to make them high. If Jesus ain't doing it for you, I would give you something. See, Satan want to give you stuff quick.
Yeah.
Yes.
He want to. If Jesus ain't doing it quick enough for God people,
yes,
they'll run to the devil and bow down
Jesus.
To them.
That's true.
And Jesus said, "It is written."
That's true.
It is written in God's word. He told us to stand still.
Yes.
He said he will fight our battle. He said in his word, it's written. So we got to use God's word against the devil. Because the devil don't have nothing. He don't have nothing. What we got to offer to Jesus, the devil can't give us. He just give you trouble. He give you heartaches. He give you pain. He make you sick in your body. He wants you towed down. He don't want you to do nothing. He wants you to serve him. Just say, I got you. I got you, but Jesus said, it is written. You cannot live by bread alone.
Mm-hmm.
Because every word proceeds out of the mouth of God, he said, feed. I will feed you if you just read about me. I will feed you. And when the devil comes, he said, I will stop him. But you got to do something.
Mm-hmm.
That's what God said. What are we doing? When little things come to our mind, that old evil spirit, that old gossip spirit, that old jealousy spirit. What we doing? God said, you need to say what I told you to say. Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Because I'm telling you, he had tried me. He had tried me plenty of time. But God let me know, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. You shall worship the Lord.
That's right.
I don't bow down to the devil, because that's what the devil wants us to do, yes, to bow down to him. But God said, I gave you the word. I want you to speak the word. I want you to tell the devil he don't have no power over you.
Jesus.
Because it is written. And when it's written, it's true.
Jesus.
Amen for that.
It is true. Because the word, anything that God is saying according to this word, it's lined up, and he's telling you, do it.
That's right.
Because a lot of people are not doing what God told them to do. Jesus. So how can you do it when you won't even do it?
Jesus.
We do partial.
Jesus.
We do partial. We take what we want out the Bible. But God said, in 66 books in the Bible, you got to do the whole roll. And when you're doing the whole roll, you got to do what God from the what? From where? From Genesis to Revelation.
Yes.
And when we don't do it, we think, okay, well, Lord, I'm going to do this one right here. But God said, what about this one right here? I've written this, and I want you to do this. And but we don't want to hear it, because Satan, some way Satan try to get our mind. Don't listen to what they say. You go ahead and do what I told you to do. You do it the way you want to do. Jesus said you're going to be in trouble. He said it's written. It's written. And when it's written, that means we got to do what God told us to do. Because we can't go there and start, oh Lord, you get the shaking and oh Jesus, oh the devil. Jesus said, what I told you to do? Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. He shall bow down to Jesus.
Yes.
So we need to stop bowing down. Because guess what? Even the devil even said, if you read it, if you read verse 6, he even told him, it's written. He said, it's written. So he was telling him, I want you to bow down to me. But Jesus, I'm not bowing down to you. You bow down to me. And you worship me only. So we got to worship God only. Because,
get on that, lay down.
Thank you, Lord. All over the world, people are bowing down to man like this. They bowing down to these. Though they're standing up here, though they're standing up there. God said, who you putting your trust in? Man or me? Because man can't get you out. Like I can. That's what they're doing. They making them like a pedestal. Like Satan said, I put you up in the kingdom. These people are putting people up like a kingdom. They putting them up on a pedestal. And but God said, that's not God. I'm the God. I'm the true living God. I am Jesus. I'm the one that raised you up and gave you breath. And that's what they doing.
You're both strong today.
Jesus.
They making these people out of idols. And God said, ain't man one of them worshiping him. We got to be careful what we doing before God. We got to do what this word say. He said it's written. It's written. He said man should not live by bread alone. That's what he said. But he said every word. He didn't say two or three words. He said every word. Every word.
Yes.
That proceeded out the mouth of God.
Yes.
And that's what he meant.
Yes.
And that's what he stands for. We got to do what he said to do. Stop letting Satan come to us and shake us up. Jesus said, use this. Start using his word. Start using it. When he come to you, your body, when you're feeling bad in your body, Jesus said, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Because Jesus said, I already healed you from the beginning.
That's right.
He's already healed you.
Yes.
So don't let him shake you. Yes. Don't let him move you. Because that's what the devil is out here to do.
Yes.
It's to move you. He don't want you using God's word. He wants you to use your own word.
Jesus.
But you can't get that through your own word. You got to get it through the word of God.
Yes.
So that's what the devil wants us to do. He wants you to what? Bow down to him.
Yes.
He wants to give you everything. But Jesus said, I can give you everything.
Yes.
So we got to understand, it is written.
Yes.
It is written.
It is written.
It is written. Because
yes.
God wrote the Bible.
Jesus.
It is written.
Yes.
So Lord was telling me to tell the people of God, Yes. Anything that's coming to us, that's trying to shake us,
Jesus,
that's trying to move us,
yes,
any sickness, anything come to your mind that is not of God, we already know who it is.
Amen.
And Jesus wants you to use this. Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And when he said that, what you think Satan did? Yes, he did.
Yes.
He left. When any time that spirit come to you, anything, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God.
Yes.
God said, you worship me. You bow down and worship me.
Right.
So we can say this. A lot of people think, yes, you can. You can say it.
Mm-hmm.
We are his children. And anything that is not right coming to us, we can use this. Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God.
Yes.
You shall bow down and worship the Lord. You know, the Lord.
Yes.
That's what Jesus was telling us. Use it and see what happened. Anytime he tried to come to your mind, on your job, in your home, any little thing that's not of God,
Jesus,
and that thing, you see it coming, you say, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Thou shalt not tempt the Lord. And watch when the Savior said, he'll be away from you quick.
Jesus.
Because he can't, he don't like the name of Jesus.
No, he don't.
He don't like Jesus. He don't. He don't like Jesus.
Yes.
When you say, Jesus, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And he's gone. He's gone. So now remember that. It is written.
It is written.
It is written. Because I thank God for that. It is written. So anything trying to come up against you, try to make you move, try to make you go up against what God said, you remember who's doing that to you. That's Satan himself. So you just had to tell him, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And guess what? He's going away from him.
That's right. That's
and that's right. All Jesus gave to me.
Mm-hmm.
It is written.
Mm-hmm.
So y'all pray for me.
Mm-hmm.
I thank God for the word because it came to me. Because I thank God for it. Because
yes,
it is written.
Yes.
When he said it's written, I can't go up against what the word says.
That's right.
If it's in the Bible, if Jesus said do this right here, that's what he said.
Right.
If he said come out among them, that's what he said.
Yes.
If he said fornication, no lying, blasphemy, I got to do what God said. That's what's written in the Bible. If he said, that's what he mean.
Yes.
I can't go up against God. Because if I go against God, oh my God. What he said,
right.
You can't kick against the priest. Because when I kick against him like this, ow!
Yes.
Ow! You're going to get hurt. Because Jesus is too big for us to go against.
Yes.
And when he said, that's what he meant.
Yes.
We cannot fight against God.
Mm-hmm.
When it's written, it's already been laid out for
us. Amen.
So y'all pray for me. Wherever God have me be in his kingdom.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.